acting is like a big thing. So when we had this theater group come and coach us, we were like, wow, we're learning acting and, you know, things like that.
I'm Tulika Sharma and I'll be taking your interview today. So first of all, congratulations on doing such a great job. So since you have your step in acting, so I would like to talk to you about that first. What are the domains of your work and how do you approach them?
So basically, I'm essentially an acting coach. I act sometimes here and there. And I direct plays and I direct short films. So I'll tell you why so many things. So firstly, when I came here to Mumbai, I had already worked as an actor for about 3 years in Chennai. So I had, by the time I actually came to Mumbai, I had actually done one whole TV show down south. I did 1 year of television. I did say about 7 to 8 short films. I worked in about 25-30 advertisements. So I had already done that and I had come here. And when I actually came here and I actually studied the field, like the ground, you know, where people go and audition and people actually get selected. One thing that I realized is that a lot of actors struggle for about 5-6 months. They get one ad and they're so elated and so happy. Okay. But what next? You know, so the uncertainty was always there. And the uncertainty, I think, is there in the pulse of the industry. And that's exactly why I said, you know what, it's fine. I would be a part of this industry. I just want to be known for my artistic skills. So it's fine if I have to direct. It's fine if I have to do act. And I was always a trainer. So I think that's why I said, you know what, let me just put my acting behind, let it take a back seat. And then that's how I started writing. I started directing. I started directing stage plays. I started coaching actors. And that's exactly how it, all of this happened.
That's great. That's quite a journey, I must say.
Yeah.
So you mentioned something about people skill. So can you throw some light on that?
Okay. So, I started working when I was 18 and I started training people in soft skills and personality development much before I actually got into acting. So, one thing that I have realized over the course of my entire career is that you need to have exceptional people skills. If you know how to read and talk to people, everything is sorted. Correct. Like a very simple thing, ki agar samne wala banda keh raha hai ki ye theek nahi hai, or you want to tell the other person that this is not right, you can still say it. All that you have to do is you have to choose the right words and the right tonality to communicate the same.
Correct. Absolutely.
And at the end of the day, I think in this industry where we're all trying to actually connect with the audience, whether it is an actor, whether it is a director, at the end of the day, your job is to connect with people who watch your content and watch your stories. So one thing that I think all the actors, all the artists should know is that you need to know how to connect with people. And by connecting with people, I do not mean to say that you have to go networking, you have to go partying, you have to go all of that. But it's whenever you work, I think you need to have a very good bond, a very good vibe with each other and then work. I think that sorts a lot of it. Yeah.
Right. So can you tell us something about your acting career, like in theater?
In theater. Okay. So my first ever training and acting actually started off with a theater group called Avam Entertainment in Chennai. They had actually come down to Coimbatore from where I come. And so Coimbatore back then, small town, you know, acting is like a big thing. So when we had this theater group come and coach us, we were like, wow, we're learning acting and, you know, things like that. So we were so excited about the whole process. I started off training there, and then after that training, I realized that maybe, yeah, this is something that I'm good at, I should be doing. And I started off my theater, performing in theater almost when I was 17. Yes. When I was 17, it's almost now 14, 15 years.
Wow.
And yeah, 14, 15 years. And then I've done multiple plays, multiple adaptations, a great number of shows in Chennai. When I came to Mumbai, I realized that beta agar paise kamane hai to theater to shayad nahi kuch aur kar lo. So I do theater now. I do it because I feel theater actors, theater artists, theater practitioners are way, way, way more superior than the film stars or the film actors in terms of the skill. Because to hold the audience, for 2 hours and not bore them live, it's another level of skill that you need. Right. And yes, it's been, if I have to sum it all, it's been like 14 years in theater, direction, acting, everything. Yes.
You are just a pack of talent, it seems.
You've been kind.
So what, according to you, should be the attitude of an artist while working in theater?
This is something that I learned very, very recently. One thing is that the artist has to be in a happy space. Okay, he can't be brooding, he can't be mulling over things, he can't be whining over things not working in his favor, and wanting to go perform on stage. So firstly, I think the approach towards work has to be as if you're worshipping it. So firstly, be in a great mental space. Enjoy what you're doing. That's very, very important, because unless and until you're not enjoying it, it's going to show up in your work. So that's attitude number one. I think enjoy your work. And second, the industry that we are joining in, there's already a lot of dirt. There's already a lot of mess. So I think we should now actually be the people who are sort of wanting to clean the mess rather than to get dirty alongside.
With that, right.
So I think ethical, talking to people, getting permissions, just working the right way, that I think should be the second approach towards your work. And lastly, I feel whatever you do in your career, whether it is a small play vis-a-vis a film or whatever, there will always be a sect of people who will not like your work. Okay, there will always be people who want to diss you. There will always be people who actually want to put you down. So the third and the last thing that I have learned is, do your bit and give a damn. It's fine. I know you want to actually tell the story to the audience. You want the entire audience to actually applaud for you and connect with you and be happy and all of that. Nice. But at the end of the day, you should also know as an artist when to disconnect from your audience and not let the opinions of people affect you.
Right. I think somewhere or the other, these kind of dislike, the reviews, dislike reviews and negative reviews actually help you to motivate you towards doing it more perfectly.
Yes, you're right. I wouldn't deny that at all. But how I look at it is that I'm a very, very strong critique of my own work. Okay. So if I'm happy with my efforts, nobody will understand your backstory. Nobody will know with what kind of situation, circumstances and budgets have you made a certain film. Or let's just say, or have you put up an act. An audience is going to come see you and they say, you're horrible on stage. You were not, he was not good at all. But for all you know, he might have just battled a serious accident and he might have just come.
Right.
The actor. So you never know what's actually going on behind. So I personally don't, I want to perform for the audience. I want the audience to like my work. But if it doesn't so, then I think I'm the best critique for my own work. I look at myself that way.
Right. One should be, fulfilling ourselves first.
If you're happy with your work and knowing the circumstances and the situations that you have been and the stuff that you put out, if you're happy, then it's fine.
So how do you approach a character in while you're acting or while you are directing something. So how do you approach it?
I think while acting is pretty well, I mean, there are these techniques that are that come from the text, from the script. I mean, the script many a times will tell you the flavor or the overall shape of the character. Mm-hmm. And then obviously then you sit down with the director and or the auditioner and probably try and understand as to how they would like to see the character in what light.
Mm-hmm.
So the approach of the character while you're acting is slightly different from the way a director sees it.
Okay.
I think when I direct, I seek a lot of character references from real life, like people around me, like maybe my past, a little element of me within, you know, some things like that. So while I'm directing it, I actually seek a lot of it from the real life. But while I'm performing, I generally like to sit with the director, try and understand his vision, and then probably look for sources. And
I think that is the perfect way to do it.
100 other ways, but I think to each his own.
Right. So what are the struggles while becoming an artist? Because, you know, there are financial problems, there are societal pressures, there are financially settled hoja from the family.
I just feel we should look at it as a challenge and try and see if you're so focused and so goal oriented, then I think you should see how you can move past the challenge and probably make it work.
Right.
I think that. And secondly, I'll tell you what, Tulika. So I meet at least 40 odd new people in a month. Okay. Where, 40 to 50 odd new people in a month. Okay. Where I'm working with them. So one thing that I've realized of the last 7 years of me being in Mumbai is that people come to become a star, not because they like acting, not because they like direction, not because they are artists by soul, not because they are actually creative or they actually want to say a story out or, you know, share something with the public. But basically, wo yahan par aate hain star banne. Matlab famous hona hai, amazing ghar hona hai, beautiful DVR, ek amazing hot sa husband hona chahiye. And gaadiyan beshumar. So I think that's the perception that people come here with. But there are so many actors who are happy in their life, who made fantastic lives out of their career, but they're not very popular.
Right.
But they're doing some great work now and then. And I know a couple of people who do say about 3 to 4 ads a month, and they're sort of, I mean, they're very happy. Not that they're not ambitious, not that they're not wanting to grow ahead, not that they're not seeking any opportunity ahead, but they're in a great space. Agar tum success ko abhi kisi aur ke success ke hisab se napoge, then there is no end at all. Na?
Yeah, that is the comparing you with, you know, n number of people. There is a whole list to it. Like, you can compare yourself to Mr. Ambani as well. You'd be poor.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So I think when it comes to the struggle or the challenges, ye sabki zindagi mein honge honge, artist ki zindagi mein. But I think usko struggle nahi dekhna chahiye, usko as a challenge dekhna chahiye, and you should see how you can move past it and then probably be ready for another challenge.
Right. So kahin na kahin society bhi ek barrier banti hai isme when you pursue something like this.
See, thankfully, I don't know anything much about it because my family has been extremely, extremely supportive.
That is and, very lucky.
Yeah, nobody actually told me, yaar, tujhe nahin karna chahiye. So I genuinely have no idea about that. But I, of course, come across a lot of my trainees, a lot of my students, a lot of actors who battle hardships at home. And sahi to nahi hai, but I don't think, matlab, this is a problem with India, na, log kya kahenge ab? Uska, I don't know uska solution kya nikal sakta hai. But yeah, people should be allowed to do what they want to do, because later I don't think it's right to hold regrets. It's not right to actually say that, yaar, maine ye nahi kiya, and all of that. Thankfully, I haven't experienced any of that societal pressure or struggle or challenges.
That is great.
Yeah, thankfully. And I think I have been able to work so happily in a great space only because my family's always been supportive.
Right. Otherwise, there would have been a lot of pressure.
Yeah, absolutely. Or insan kaam kaise kar payega? Matlab, agar if he has to prove himself everywhere, how is he even, if the pressure of proving is on your head every time, how are you going to explore the creative side of you? How are you going to put right. things out?
Right. You're right. Also, there are a lot of people who go through this, and कहीं ना कहीं लोग इसी की वजह से restrict कर जाते हैं towards pursuing something like this.
Yeah, of course, there's a lot of parents in India who feel that you know the industry is not so great, and यहाँ पर अभी भी I think कहीं ना कहीं लोगों को ये perception लगता है कि यार ये तो इसको कुछ नहीं आता तो इसको एक्टर बना दो बट दे हैव नो आइडिया व्हाट इट टेक्स फॉर अ पर्सन टू गो ऑन स्टेज एंड परफॉर्म वन फुल लेंथ प्ले द काइंड ऑफ स्किल्स दैट यू नीड एंड टू मास्टर इट नॉट जस्ट डू इट फॉर द सेक ऑफ डूइंग इट बट टू मास्टर इट सो आई थिंक द परसेप्शन ऑफ पीपल इन द कंट्री शुड चेंज एंड ऑल्सो नाउ ऑफ लेट बिकॉज because the industry is in the limelight and because people talk about it there are perceptions ki yaar nahi dekho abhi is industry mein log depress ho rahe hain jaise ki log baki ke industry mein depress nahi ho rahe hain
right
quite natural quite har depression kisi bhi industry mein kisi bhi profession mein aa sakta hai but acting in the here it is seen more because it is in the limelight
right
that's that
I think acceptance is something people should focus on.
Yeah, acceptance to must self acceptance and plus the
societal
family's
acceptance. Yeah. Correct. So, do you think people actually they have a misconception and they are not clear with the idea of cinema and theater? They usually mix it with, "Arey, isne theater kiya hai, to aage jaake iska actor hi banna hai," or something like that.
Firstly, main ye bata dun. क्योंकि मैं थिएटर से जुड़ा हुआ हूँ पिछले इतने सालों से मैं चाहूंगा कि हर वो इंसान जिंदगी में जो भी कर रहा है इवन इफ इट इज अ डॉक्टर अ लॉयर अ बैंकर आप जो भी हो जिंदगी में एक प्ले जरूर करो आपको पता चलेगा वो 3 महीने अपने आप को दे दो और आपको पता चलेगा कि आपकी जिंदगी ना बदल चुकी है So theater is not for you to become an actor. Theater is for you to explore the creative side of you, become more confident, face the public, how confident that you can become in front of people. Say so many number of eyes looking at you, judging you, and yet be so in your own space under the lights and probably experience being in the moment. Yes. So I feel theater is a great place for the actors to polish their craft and work on their craft but that does not mean the theater does not belong to anybody else I think sabko zindagi mein ek play to karna hi chahiye find an audience and stage your play for an audience you will realize theater does so much to you personally you grow as an individual like aapko team work kya hota hai wo samajh mein aayega aapke interpersonal skills better honge aapke right. communication skills better honge aapke body aapka body language better hoga aapka presence of mind better hoga aapko nervousness battle karne ka strength milega so life mein aap kabhi nervousness jab bhi experience karoge aapko malum hai that aapne ye kar diya to ye kya hi jeeta
right
so theater is not theater is always misconceptualized that way and cinema of course cinema ka to alag hi game hai cinema is huge cinema is larger than life everybody wants to be on that big screen once
right.
see them ha but theater aur iska jod you shouldn't actually relate theater and cinema together
right because actually 2 days back I took an interview and the person said that whenever you know there's a group of friends and they're sitting like they're like kya kare bore ho rahe let's go for a movie nobody says that let's go to see a play and yeah. that really hit me that is true that is very true
the audience is very low or very less for a live performance एंड ऑल्सो इफ यू सी सिनेमा कल्चर इज बिगर देन द थिएटर कल्चर ना, मतलब अगर आप थिएटर देखोगे स्ट्रॉन्गली कहां पर है, इट्स ओनली द मेट्रोपॉलिटन सिटीज दैट हैव अ स्ट्रॉन्ग थिएटर कल्चर. सो ऑल्सो द रीच ऑफ थिएटर इज वेरी मिनिमल कंपेयर टू सिनेमा. सिनेमा गाँव गाँव तक पहुंच जाता है, आपके वीडियो आपका आपके सेलफोन्स पर सिनेमा है, बट थिएटर इज नॉट दैट. सो ऑब्वियसली द ऑडियंस इज ऑल्सो लिमिटेड एंड देर टू डिफरेंट मीडियम्स, देर टू डिफरेंट platforms altogether. I don't think they should actually be compared at all.
Right. I think since everything is going digital now, like the movies, the OTT platform, then everything is going digital nowadays. So even the theater, we see that Zee Cinema is coming, Zee Theater is coming up. So we see the pre-recorded theater scenes and the whole play. So do you think they're going to lose the essence? Because I think there's a difference between seeing it in an auditorium in a hall and then compared to seeing on a phone.
Yeah, I think jo maza cinema hall mein like wo laptop ya phone screens mein mile. Like I will do anything, go watch a Sanjay Leela Bhansali film in a huge canvas. अगर वो मैंने उसको लैपटॉप पे देख लिया या फोन पे देख लिया तो मेरा सारा इट्स आई हैव लॉस्ट द एंटायर एंटरटेनमेंट वैल्यू ऑफ द फिल्म. आई थिंक इवन दो द गेम इज चेंजिंग राइट नाउ, इवन दो पीपल आर ट्राइंग टू एक्चुअली मेक थिंग्स अवेलेबल ऑन द सेलफोन एंड ऑन द डिवाइसेस, एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग डिजिटल, बट आई डोंट थिंक द सिनेमा, मे बी इन द बिजनेस एंड द नंबर्स देयर माइट बी फ्लक्चुएशंस एंड ऑल ऑफ दैट, बट इट विल नेवर लूज द वैल्यू. Like a huge watching a cinema in cinema halls, I don't think it's gonna ever lose its value. It's like reading e-books vis-a-vis books. मतलब आज जितने हमने e-books हम बैटरी devices पे पढ़ रहे हैं, but एक किताब को खोल के उसको सूंघने में and to smell it and enjoy its beauty,
right.
Reading it with a hard copy, that never dies.
Correct. Right. I think. थिएटर को आई थिंक ऑडिटोरियम तक ही अभी तक लिमिट रखना चाहिए.
आई विश, आई होप.
राइट, सो थैंक यू सो मच फॉर कनेक्टिंग विद अस एंड इट वाज ग्रेट टॉकिंग टू यू. एंड आई थिंक आप जो भी काम कर रहे हो, डायरेक्शन, द एक्टिंग, एवरीथिंग इज गोइंग, यू आर डूइंग अ फिनोमिनल जॉब.
थैंक यू सो मच सुलिका, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर हैविंग मी, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर एक्चुअली आस्किंग मी टू डू दिस. And yeah, we will always be crossing paths.
Sure, definitely.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.